You're nearly there, Peter.
I got it, Mom.
Thanks, baby.
Another headache?
Just a little one. Stop worrying. It's fine. Just took me by surprise.
I wish I could help.
I know you do. Some things, Peter, they're not yours to control. I better get that prescription before the pharmacy closes. Stay out of trouble till I get back, okay? Be good. I know that's not always easy for you.
I'll be a perfect little angel. Like always.
I better hurry back then. I'll be back soon.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, Mr. Pinkle.
Here to get that mixtape copied?
Yeah.
Sure is a nice thing to do for your mom. How's she doing, anyway?
She's not doing so well.
I'm sorry to hear that, Pete. Well, I'm sure this is gonna make her feel a lot better. Music's got some powerful mojo. Both sides? Come back in about an hour, and it'll be ready.
Hey, Petey! You make that mix for your boyfriend?
Oh, shut up, Clarence.
You brain dead kid? I've told everybody a million times I go by my last name, King. Afraid I'm gonna break it again?
You afraid I'm gonna hit you again?
Listen to you. Pretending you got balls. Hey! How's that lip doing? Give me that. What are you doing here anyway? You don't have money. Everyone in town's talking about it. Your mom can't even pay her medical bills. She's been going door to door asking for help like some pathetic loser. She's probably off looking for change in the sewers right now.
Come on. Let's not do this, man.
Do what?
We're just talking.
You gonna cry now? Huh?
You done yet? Elephant ears? You must get great reception with those things.
Nah, I'm not done. But your mom? She sure is. My dad goes drinking with her doctor. Told him everything. Guess she didn't feel like it was important enough to tell you. Oh, check it out. Dead woman walking. What's the point? Drugs ain't gonna help. My dad says you're gonna die anyway.
My mom's gonna be fine. She just needs the right medicine.
Get her some poison. At least then she won't be wasting money trying to get better.
Get out!
My dad's gonna...
Out!
You kept your promise. You didn't fight that jerk. I'm proud of you, Peter. Even though I didn't set a very good example. The things he said. I let my emotions get the better of me.
I'm sorry you heard that.
No, Peter. It's okay.
He said you were dying, Mom. Is that true?
Find me, please. You're so close, Peter.
What the? How did I get home?
Gamora!
Harder.
Hey. Are you okay? Because this temple is really messing with my head.
Hello, Gamora. Whoa! Hey, Gamora!
Come on, what? Nebula.
What are you doing?
You can do better than that.
Not Nebula. It's me, Peter, who you like a whole lot and definitely do not want to kill! Come on, this isn't fair! I don't have a sword!
Focus, Nebula. You need to be aware of everything around you. Perception's just as important as strength and speed.
None of them are important when I'm stuck here. I want to use what you've taught me somewhere outside of this room. I'm sick of just doing the same thing over and over, every single day.
Be patient, Nebula. You'll get your chance soon enough.
So now I need patience, too? Looks like you've lost your touch.
Hardly.
That was actually a little impressive.
Just a little?
Gamora, you're hurting me!
Great.
Nebula, you have grown so much.
Father.
You may yet be the greatest assassin in the galaxy. Don't you agree, Gamora?
I do. She's come a long way.
What a pleasant surprise. Perhaps being bested by your sister recalled the importance of humility. I have a mission for you. You will go to a Kree outpost on the planet of Phalion. There you will find General Tarval. He has come into possession of something I require, a device. Gamora, you will fetch the device for me. You, Nebula, you will kill the General.
Thank you, Father. I promise you, I will succeed.
I know you will, daughter. Gamora, you were always my favorite, but you have become cold, distant.
We will not disappoint you, Father.
But you already have, Gamora. Otherwise, you would not be taking Nebula with you. Go and prepare. You will head out immediately. And Gamora, I know you no longer care. But if you fail, your sister will pay for your missteps. Tell Nebula I wish to speak with her.
Is everything all right? What's going on? I couldn't hear you, but Father, you didn't look happy.
I can't stand this place anymore. I can't stand him anymore.
Nebula! Come here!
I guess this is it. My chance to prove myself. Or fail miserably.
Good luck, Nebula.
I don't need luck. You train me for this. I won't let you or Father down. Let's just do this. Nebula! Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What? I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me! My father will be so upset with me.
You distracted him. I killed him. We did this together.
But Father...
Thanos can complain about who did what all he wants. I don't care.
Father... Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me, now! I'm not asking here. Do it! Gamora, hand it over.
Fine. Here.
Hey, it's going to be fine. We're going to be okay.
I was trying to snap you out of it before you killed me.
Well, that's not the way to do it.
Well, apparently it was. Stop. Stop slapping me. Stop it. Okay. Uncle.
Don't do that again. I don't know what happened. One minute you and I were walking into the temple, and the next
I know.
Wait, were you... Did you see all that? My memory?
You okay?
I've been trying not to think of that day. Because I really want to fix things with Nebula. But seeing that... She thought I was being selfish. Taking away everything she worked so hard to achieve. That's why she turned on me. And why she'll never forgive what I did.
I saw what happened. You were just trying to protect her. You can't blame yourself for that.
I'm not so sure. That last moment, it became everything. All I remembered of her. But there were times we were happy. Despite Thanos, despite everything, we had each other. Maybe I could have done more. Been more honest with how I was feeling. Stop just seeing her as someone I needed to protect.
You can't change the past, Gamora. She is who she is.
That's exactly it, Peter. Nebula is who she is because of me. That hatred, that coldness, her inability to trust anyone. She is Thanos' daughter. Who else could she be after I betrayed her? I failed her.
Listen to me. You didn't fail her. You don't fail at anything. You are the strongest person I know, okay? And I respect the hell out of you for that. And I don't just mean the ass-kicking. I mean, believe me, you kick some serious ass.
I do kick a lot of ass, huh?
Hell yeah, you do. Now, come on. Let's figure out why the Forge brought us here before things get even more... weird. Oh, man. My mom loved this song. She played that record non-stop.
Peter, wait. This place... it seems to be using our memories against us. We don't know what we'll find inside. Or why it's been drawing us here.
Yeah, well, if anything goes wrong, you'll be here to protect me, right? You're not saying anything, and it's super worrying. Gamora, seriously?
Recognize this place?
Yeah. This is where my mom... This is where I saw her last.
I don't know what all this means, Peter. But I hope somehow you get your mom back.
Only one way to find out.
are you?
You have known me for a while now.
Not your mom, right?
Definitely not.
You came for me. After all these... Ooh, what are these? They're very shiny.
Hey, over here.
Peter Quill. You're really here. It's been centuries. No, millennia.
How do you know who I am?
We have met. But I was not me. For a moment.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen.
Very well, then.
Wow, didn't see that coming.
It is so wonderful to be free of that tomb. No longer trapped in my own mind. Alone. You are truly the hero the legends foretold. So brave and handsome. Though perhaps not in the classical sense.
What?
Ha! You must have many questions for me.
Why were you locked in here?
So that you could find me.
Not very helpful.
I have been waiting for you all this time. The moment you touched the forge, I knew you were the Celestial One, that you could free me. So I reached out to you the only way I could, through your memories. The ones most vivid to you. But you must understand, I had no control over them. Oh no, that is not what I wanted at all. I am so sorry. I truly did not know you'd feel so violated. I'd hoped you would feel glad to see her again. I did not mean for my abilities to hurt you.
How?
Your mind is clouded with so many emotions, so you seek answers. But those answers will not help you.
How could you possibly know how he feels?
I can show you, Angry Lady. Oh, no. Never mind. May I show you? Please, I mean no harm.
Do it again! Come on!
With great pleasure!
Oh, this isn't going to go well.
Sorry. Inside joke. You wouldn't get it.
Oh, boy.
You see, I am an empath. I can read the emotions of others. It is my duty to help the Celestial One decide the fate of the Forge.
That could really come in handy. Oh, she's gotta meet the rest of the group.
Yeah. Introduce an emotionally charged being to a group who are emotionally sensitive. Who should we try on first?
I got just the one.
What is this? Why are her head tentacles glowing?
The big green tattoo man is filled with sadness.
What? No!
He lacks direction.
I do not lack direction. Only once have I required a map.
Now he is ashamed for his outburst.
Mantis,
is an empath, Drax. She can sense your emotions.
I do not show emotion!
She's also the one who made us relive our memories.
That was you? We went halfway across the galaxy, got chased by that psycho Hala for a party trick?
It is my job to guide the Celestial One.
What the hell does that mean?
The Celestial One?
You messed with our minds. Why?
She knows about the Eternity Forge. She says she's connected to it.
That's supposed to make me less confused?
Oh, I can explain. Long ago...
Wait. Are you gonna spew some long mumbo-jumbo about where you come from and why I should care?
Yes. Is that a problem?
Remember Thanos? Going on like, now that I got this, I'm gonna roll through the galaxy like a giant turd and blah, blah, blah.
Well, I, for one, wanna hear it. All of it.
Then it's time for a nap.
Go ahead, Mantis. Enlighten us.
Of course, Peter Quill. I have communicated only through my feelings for years. It is nice to communicate with my mouth. Eons ago, the Eternity Forge coalesced into existence as a way to balance the life energy of the universe. To create, you must destroy. And to destroy, you must create. But such colossal power cannot be wielded lightly. So I was brought in to ensure that the Forge was only wielded by someone deserving, and to help guide the wielder down the right path. But I waited and waited. Years went by. Many unworthy tried to use the Forge. Some even tried to force me to help them. The Kree decided that no culture had matured enough to use the Forge with the wisdom required. Eventually, the Forge and I were separated, locked away until a time when civilizations could reach the peak of wisdom and maturity. And that is only the beginning.
Well, thanks a lot for that, Pete.
What an interesting and relevant story. Aren't you glad we heard it all, champ?
Someday, Quill, I'm gonna blast you out an airlock.
I have not yet gotten to the most important part.
Kill me.
There is a legend of the Celestial One, the chosen one who shall arrive from the stars to use the Eternity Forge.
This Celestial One, what are they like?
Advanced intellect, emotionally mature, wise being capable of navigating the dark waters of immense power. Someone who can see beyond his own selfish desires to choose for the greater good.
That describes me pretty perfectly.
Hey, come on, guys. Hey, knock it off.
It is not funny. Peter is the Celestial One.
Oh, you're so full of crap, lady. If Pete is this Celestial What's-It, then why didn't the stupid Forge work?
Sure, it brought him back. But when we tried to use it again on someone else, it didn't do a damn thing.
Your loss. I can feel it has been with you for some time. The Forge is limited right now. It can only restore life to a body that is mostly whole and undeteriorated.
I am Groot.
Well, that sucks.
Who is sucking what?
No, he means that is unfortunate.
It does not have to suck.
What do we gotta do?
The Celestial One must deliver the Forge to the Sacred Shrine. There you can unlock its true power, or destroy it forever.
And that true power is what?
Returning anyone, from any time period, back to the realm of the living. Lost ones, loved ones, I suppose hated ones too, if you were so inclined.
You can bring back anyone? Like, anyone at all?
Anyone who ever existed can be brought back, so long as you have the required energy, of course. One life for one life,
So someone still has to die for the thing to work.
Then let's finish our drinks and go use this thing.
Yes!
Really? Who are you planning to kill?
Well, you're kind of annoying me right now.
Hala wants to use this forge to raise her army. We have to destroy it.
Not until my family is returned to me.
I am Groot.
Right? Groot says he's on my side. That's 3-1, Gamora. We win.
That is not true. Groot feels the opposite.
Maybe something got lost in translation. Hey, you try understanding I am Groot all the time.
Okay, not cool, man. Don't lie to us.
I'm sorry, I just don't want that thing destroyed until we use it. Oh, and lying to you, that was a one-time thing.
I am Groot?
Okay, a two-time thing.
So, it is a tie then.
Two for using it.
I am Groot.
I'm gonna take a guess. He said two for destroying it.
Don't you get what this means? We can bring back anyone that we lost.
At a cost.
Wow. Okay, this is, it's a lot to process here. Kind of heavy on the responsibility, you know? Let me think on it. Well, one way or another, this all ends at the shrine. Can you take us there, Mantis?
I have never been. But with your help, I believe I can sense its location. May we have some space to concentrate?
Gladly. If anyone needs me, I'll be emotionally unavailable.
And that's new.
Ha ha ha.
So... am I doing this right, or...?
It is easier if you don't talk.
Oh, yeah. Okay, yeah. I'm not talking.
I cannot sense the shrine. There is so much unrest among your crew. Their emotions are overwhelming me. They look to you for guidance. Help them.
Tell me to calm down.
Because you just had to let
everything okay here?
Not now. Just give us a minute, please.
Hey there, Groot. Oh. Is that a friend of yours?
I am Groot.
I'll tell you this. We're all gonna be okay. No matter what happens with the Forge.
I am Groot.
Drax, how are you doing?
I was angry that you did not allow me to guard Nebula. But now, I am hopeful. The Forge can bring my family back, if you choose to use it.
Well...
So I must trust you would not take away my chance to reunite with my wife and daughter. Even though you did not behave in a trustworthy manner.
Huh?
You had no right to have the antenna woman do that to me. You did not even ask my permission.
Hey, look, calm down. It was just a joke. No harm meant by it.
I do not like what you call a joke. She told me I was afraid. I do not like to feel afraid. Such feelings bring me great shame. But talking to you, a frequently scared person, has helped.
Yeah. Anytime, Drax. Gamora. I need to talk to you.
Later.
Okay. Later. I get it.
Hey, bud. What's up?
Well, if it ain't Captain Indecision...
What? Are you...
I don't know what's holding you back from doing the right thing here, Quill. I mean, I can count on one paw how many folks ever get a chance to bring back someone they love.
I am Groot.
I'm not gonna kill someone to use this thing. End of story.
You already did. We killed Thanos, remember? And it saved you. You know, come to think of it, I wish the Forge had never brought you back. Yeah.
I am Groot. I am Groot.
You're right. You're right. I deserve that. I'm sorry, Pete. Come on. Come on. Have a drink with me. Alcohol cleans all sorts of wounds. That's what I'm talking about. Hey, P. You know what you...
Well, that's one way to deal with emotions.
I am Groot.
Fine. Fine!
Hey, are you okay? What the hell was that?
I tried to say everything I could think of. I thought maybe if I asked her to stick around for a while... Ugh. She won't hear it. Not from me. She'll barely even look at me.
So don't give up on her. Family is always worth it.
I know, I'm really trying. But I just can't find the right words with her. But maybe if we had more time, I could try talking to her again when she's calmed down. Give her some space without losing her altogether.
Well, they say time heals all wounds.
Who's they?
I have no idea.
Maybe I can get her to hang around. Just maybe not right now. Think she needs some alone time.
Hey, Nebula. Yeah, hey, it's me, Peter Quill, but, yeah, but you know that. You mind if I sit? Cool, yeah, this is really... How's the arm?
It's not bad. Would have come in handy to have both arms while fighting off the Kree. I suppose I'm lucky you let me out at all. So, thanks, I guess.
Like I said then, it was just a trust exercise. You passed.
Pretty sure Gamora still needs convincing. Speaking of my dear sister, bet you got an earful. What'd she say about me? That I'm a waste of space. That I deserve everything I've been through.
Gamora says she still cares about you.
She sure has a funny way of showing it. Gamora doesn't even realize that she's the reason our family ended.
Yeah, well, that's not how it looked to me.
What do you mean?
When we were in the temple, I saw Gamora's memory of your last mission.
Oh, yeah? What did you see?
I saw you stab her and leave her to die.
You have no idea what really happened that day. And neither does Gamora. Not all of it, at least.
Then show me.
Now, please take my hand.
If this kills me, I'm going to kick your ass. Is everything all right? What's going on?
I can't stand this place anymore. I can't stand him anymore.
Nebula? Come here. Nebula, my favorite daughter.
Father.
Your attacks against your sister were swift, precise. You disarmed Gamora easily. I was impressed.
Gamora is a good teacher. I owe all my knowledge to her.
And yet you emerged the victor. You have clearly outgrown her teachings. There is something you must know about Gamora. She said she would not disappoint me. But I am not so sure. Every day she grows more agitated and bitter as she watches you surpass her. You've seen her lack of respect. She disobeys me time and time again. I no longer trust her. You shouldn't trust her either, Nebula. Gamora has become a risk to our family.
I know she's been difficult, but Gamora won't fail you, Father.
I caution you to be careful with your sister. That is all I ask. If she continues to be a problem, you might take her place. Stand by my side as my greatest warrior and only daughter. Gamora makes herself more useless, more unreliable with each passing day.
Father, I need Gamora. She's my teacher and my sister.
You underestimate yourself, Nebula. This mission will prove that. This is your moment. Go and prepare. Keep your communications open. I'll be monitoring the situation.
Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me!
You distracted him. I killed him. We did this together.
But Father...
Thanos can complain about who did what all he wants. I don't care.
Nebula.
Father...
You don't need Gamora anymore. And neither do I. If you don't get rid of her, I will do it myself. Only I will ensure that your sister suffers greatly.
Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me, now!
I'm not asking here.
Fine. Here.
Hey, it's going to be fine. We're going to be okay.
Done.
What's going on? making him see?
It wasn't over.
She showed me your last mission together.
I tried to show him what really happened with Tarval, but you interrupted us.
I'm sorry. I didn't know what was going on.
But you naturally assumed the worst.
What do you expect after everything that's happened?
Hey!
She was always pushing against Thanos, testing his limits. What happened was her fault.
Yeah. I practically shoved that knife into my own gut. Too bad I had such terrible aim. Some assassin.
Gamora, I wasn't trying to kill you.
Oh yeah? Then what were you doing?
Because it looked exactly like you were trying to kill me.
Thanos said if she didn't do it, he'd do it himself. Only he'd make you suffer.
It's true, Gamora. I saved your
life! Admit it. You just wanted to prove you were better than me. By killing me.
If I wanted to kill you, you'd be dead! Thanos was going to kill you himself. There would have been nothing left of you. Do you know? I even checked your pulse, just to make sure you were still alive. You never got to see that part. The most important part. But I did.
That doesn't make any sense.
The only thing I know is I feel real sorry for the both of you. Man. Talk about family drama.
Well, clearly, this was pointless.
I don't know what to believe or what to do.
I'm just trying to keep us together. You're my family.
Oh, so you finally agree with me about something. What a surprise!
I'm just as surprised as you. I figured you'd disagree with me just because that's what you do.
Guys, stop! You both want the same thing!
He's actually right.
It happens sometimes.
More than sometimes. Thank you.
Maybe we could give each other a chance?
All right.
Peter, I can finally sense the shrine.
Okay. Let's go. Well, it isn't my favorite assassin sisters.
Well, that'd be a pretty rad band name.
Hey, Peter. Give me 1 second. I'll meet you in my room.
Sure.
Quill.
Thank you for talking to Nebula. It means a lot to have her here. It gives me hope.
What are you...
What?
Was that a dagger? Was it... What, you got a throwing star there? Whatever, you got something pokey on your hip.
I do not usually hug. You're a good friend, Peter.
Also, such sadness.
You are a very nostalgic person.
Hey, whoa, what's the matter? Why are you crying? Why am I crying?
Oh, God. The little box brings you so much sorrow.
Oh, God.
I'm sorry for that. Sometimes emotions overwhelm me and reflect back onto others.
Yeah, that's cool.
I'm cool. Okay.
Everyone on this ship is so poisoned by their feelings, overly focused on the past. Not living here, in the now. Experiencing all the wonderful things around you.
Like, I think it's better to focus on the future. You know, anything can be possible tomorrow.
That is a hopeful sentiment. And very naive. But sometimes you need that. Thank you for letting me listen to your music. It made me feel better. And worse at the same time. I loved it.
Hey, Mantis. Can you direct me to that magic shrine thing now?
Of course! But it is a long way, and I must concentrate completely. There can be no distraction.
I didn't know it would do that!
Oh, you have made an awe-inspiring mess.
Distractions.
I'll see what I can do.
Entrance to the shrine.
This is it.
Yay! Another temple!
The Kree were not only skilled warriors. You can find great symbolism in much of their architecture.
Yeah, they like pretty things. We get it. Now what, Pete?
Mantis? Any pointers?
It appears the forge goes there. On the altar.
Seriously? Well, that was anticlimactic.
Much better.
Not working.
Relic in place. Check. Must be something else to it.
Guys, have a look around. See if you can find anything that looks off.
I am Groot.
Of course something's wrong, because we're in a frickin' Kree temple, where everything is always more complicated than it needs to be. I mean, ain't they ever heard of an on switch?
Once we get all these statues working, are you ready for whatever happens next?
That depends on you, Pete. You know how much bringing Lila back means to me. And only you can make that happen.
We go.
No. You were saying?
Can you help me out and hold that, doohickey in place?
Good job, buddy. That forge is gonna be resurrected in no time.
I am Groot.
He says you might destroy it. That he hopes you do.
Is that really what he said? One more to go. Something tells me it's not gonna be easy.
Okay, let's see. This big guy used to stand here, holding up that giant whatever it is thingy. And things go bad. Age sets in.
Oh no, I dropped it! Ah!
So where did it go? There it goes!
It is a hologram. You are so stupid.
Shut up. I knew that.
What now, Celestial One?
Stupid jet boots overheated. Drax, I need your muscles.
You cannot have them. They are attached to me.
No, I know they... I need your help. I've got to lift something very heavy.
Ah, I see. You are weak. I will help you.
I am ready.
Reach. Hey, Rocket. I need you to grab that lens.
Getting crushed to death ain't on my list of to-dos, Pete. I'm sure if you just reach really hard, you could get it. Maybe dislocate.
You're the only one who can fit.
Ah, so it's a little guy thing. Of course. Can't be that I'm the quickest or the
smartest.
Okay. But I get smushed. I better be first in line for some resurrection!
Here.
Thanks.
Interesting.
Stop.
There is still no statue upon which to set it.
I would have gotten a lens, guys. I was just, you know, working up to it.
Yep. We just gotta, you know, work together.
Oh, you mean like a team?
What a novel idea.
Yes, teamwork often brings good feelings.
Perhaps we are doing it wrong, Ben.
Okay, listen up. I need everyone over here.
Nope, not gonna happen.
Just a little higher!
My arms can't go any higher!
Your muscles are soft.
Shut up.
Guys, stop talking.
Like a baby's bottom.
Shut up.
No! That's my face!
A very fat baby.
Sorry. Hey, what do I know about whatever you are, anatomy?
Idiots.
Maybe your people enjoy having their faces stepped.
It's done.
That mean I can drop this thing?
No.
These freaking temples. I'm gonna take dynamite to all of them.
Now it is truly time to decide. Turn the forge to the left to destroy it forever. Turn the forge to the right to empower it and bring it to its full potential.
Okay.
Wait, his right or your right?
Oh. I don't know.
What?
Let me see.
Wow. I can't believe that almost happened.
Turn it this way to destroy it. Turn it this...
Yeah, we got it. Turn it to the right, Pete.
It's left, Peter. You want your left.
Peter, you must turn it left.
No! It's right to empower you, idiot.
Oh, yes. Go right, Peter. I am Groot!
Destroying the forge is the only way we can keep it from hurting people.
Don't listen to her. Think of your mom. Think of Lila.
I am Groot.
Shut up already! He's gonna use it!
I promise you my undying loyalty if you bring my family back to me.
Don't you see, Peter? Everyone wants this power.
I'm sorry. This thing is way too powerful for anyone to wield. You gotta destroy it.
Thank you, Peter.
You don't know anything about me, lady.
Perhaps she has never lost a loved one. She has only killed the loved ones of others.
Drax!
You don't talk like that to my sister.
I will talk to Gamora in whatever manner I please, robot. I am Groot.
Oh, yeah? And what would you know about it? You're a freaking piece of wood!
The process has begun. You can release it.
I am Groot.
You can't even communicate on your own. Think I like translating for you every single time?
I am Groot!
Now you're gonna start. Drax, back me up.
You are all horrible people.
No offense, Drax, but wisdom isn't your strong suit either.
Guys, we got company!
Thank you, Peter Quill. I never could have found this shrine without you. And the tracking device Jinzar placed on your ship.
You know, I didn't think you could get more annoying than that time you killed me. You really suck.
Their usefulness has expired. Dispose of them.
Oh, I've had about enough of this.
God, boots are more busted than I thought.
How you like me now, huh? Huh?
No!
Depths, blue demon.
He knows he can just let go, right?
That's something.
big blue lady. Not the first time.
Intriguing. You let me have a minute? Sheesh. Now, where was I? Well, that was surprisingly easy. Hang on, buddy, I got you! Ah, crap.
I am Groot!
It's not like I did it on purpose. He's got a bit of a learning curve.
I am sorry to have made you sad.
Oh, we should do this more often. Looks like the boys could use some help. This won't be easy. Hope not.
No more.
Hope you're happy, Quill.
You did what needed to be done.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess so.
Uh-oh.
You took everything from me. I will destroy you and all that you love.
So now Mantis is tagging along, but she's only creating more questions than answers. About the Eternity Forge, about Hala, about everything.
Janitors of the galaxy, that's what we should be called. And Hala and the Kree, well, they're just the latest cosmic spill.
As much as he's wrong about almost everything he does, Peter was justified in his actions with the Forge.
She agreed with me? I mean, of course she did. Can I get a copy of her saying that?
It's what happened next that he should regret.